is good
all the time.
Why don't you turn to someone and say that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Okay. Well,
and I have been able to do everything through Christ who strengthened me. We want to sing about the grace of Jesus.
Amen.
And acknowledge that we are not held by our own strength and that it's been God. Amen, church.
Amen.
More than my mind can comprehend. See, I've seen the wonders of your grace. I'm so sure that this is not the end. More than our mouths can testify, and more than our minds can comprehend. See, we've seen the wonders of your grace, and I'm so sure that this is not the end. See how far you brought me. Yes, I'm so glad you found me worthy. And I can see, I can tell, and I know it's your grace. All my days I will sing your grace. Yes, far you brought me. Yes, I'm so glad you found me worthy. I can see, I can tell, and I know it's your grace. On my days I will sing your praise.
Giving up on me,
sing my heart.
My heart
is full of gratitude,
so full of gratitude
to you and no one else.
To you,
no one else.
And no one else but you,
Lord. We are seated here today,
I'm
here,
only by your grace.
Somebody lift your voice.
Come on, let's give some praise to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's remain standing as we read the word of God from Mark's Gospel. Chapter 16, the 15th verse to 20. Mark 16, verse number 15 to the 20th. Shall we hear the reading of the word of God?
Mark chapter 16, 15 to 20. And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven, and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them, and confirming the word with signs following. Amen.
Please let us pray. Heavenly Father, your word has been sent to us this morning, and we are so grateful and thankful. We pray for understanding hearts, and we pray that the word of God will convict us. So we'll be blessed, healed, and faith impacted in our hearts this morning. I thank you one more time for understanding. Let the word of God be honored in the life of this congregation. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Hallelujah. And he said unto them, referring to Jesus, he told the disciples before he was received into heaven and said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go preach the gospel to every creature. I can see creatures everywhere. Everywhere I see creatures. And I want to believe that you also see creatures everywhere. If you don't see creatures, then it means that something is wrong with your eyes. And he said, go. Turn to your neighbor and say, go. Go is an instruction. I know by now some of you may be saying in your head, Pastor is back with this instruction matter again. Well, Samuel told King Saul in 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 20. It says, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. To obey is better than what? As I was praying in the course of the week, asking God, what do I preach to your congregation this week? He says, some heard, but they never heard. I sent you to deliver a message. Go back and deliver the message. So today is the third time I'm talking about instructions. Today is what? The third time I'm talking about instructions. So go. Can I hear you tell your neighbor, go? Then find out, have you been going at all? Oh, please, don't be silent on me. I say, ask your neighbor, have you been going at all? What answer did you get? They were silent, right? Have you been going at all? To obey is better than, shout it out, to obey is better than sacrifice. Amen. The church today is so passive whenever we talk about soul winning. Sometimes you have to virtually draw amen from them. It's like by force, you have to force them to say amen. But whenever you talk about the prosperity of the Lord, it maketh rich and adds no sorrow to it. Then the church will say, and you can see smiles on everybody's face. That is not to say that the prosperity of the Lord should not be spoken about, but the prosperity of the Lord is good. And winning of souls and preaching the gospel to all creatures is as much as the preaching of the gospel of prosperity is good. As much as you preach the prosperity of the gospel, we can also preach the gospel of winning souls. So I'm only obeying what the Spirit of God told me. Amen. One sister came to me on Sunday and said she had a dream. She came to visit Mommy and I. We were sitting in my hall and we're just conversing, and it was on my birthday, which was somewhere last week. And as we were talking, I kept quiet. So I said, there's somebody on the compound, my compound. And I was behaving as if I'd seen somebody on my compound. Meanwhile, we were sitting in our hall. So virtually, it looked like my conversation had come to an end with them, and I was focusing on what was happening on the compound, and they were wondering what was it about. Then all of a sudden, somebody knocked the door, and a woman walked in with a gift of foodstuff or whatever, cooked food or something, and put it down. And she said, oh, I brought this to you for your birthday. And I didn't say anything, and the woman checked out of my sitting room. And so she became very suspicious because of the way I had behaved earlier. So she decided to follow the woman. And then when the woman got to my compound again, she started manifesting. She started manifesting. Demons were being manifested in him. And he said, oh, I see. That is why my daddy discerned when you were coming. And the woman said, why are you people praying about souls? You people are disturbing us with all this soul winning and praying about souls and church growth. Akwile, are you in church? Then she said, oh, now I understand why daddy became suspicious even when you had not entered the room. Church people will respond to anything and be excited about anything. But when it comes to talking about preaching the gospel of salvation and winning of souls, then the church becomes dead silent. It looks like you have taken away their joy. And everybody will look pensive in the church. I see there's a funeral. Look at us here this morning. So I made it clear to the sister. Yeah. When a child of God, born of the Spirit of God, tongue talking, finds it difficult to go and preach the gospel, you can tell that there's a demonic work going on. You can tell. Meanwhile, one of the greatest treasure that a believer can lay up for himself or herself is when you preach the gospel of salvation and draw souls unto God. It is the biggest treasure you have ever or you can ever lay in heaven. It is. But you see nerves being ruffled because you are talking about the preaching of the gospel. Why should nerves be touched? Why? It's demonic. It is demonic. Go and start praying and ask God to help you. So it says, go. Go is an instruction. Go is an instruction. And turn with me to Proverbs chapter 8. Two times the wise man in this chapter personified wisdom. Wisdom is speaking, and the wise man had personified wisdom. What I mean by that is wisdom is speaking, and the writer has made the wisdom look like a human being, a person. And of course, that is the person of Jesus Christ. Wisdom is the person of Jesus Christ. Verse 1 says, that not wisdom cry, and understanding put forth her voice. When you should pray that you should not marry a man who doesn't understand. So you should also pray you don't marry a man who doesn't understand or a woman who doesn't understand. Some common things that we can agree on, you will see husband and wife fighting over because one person lacks understanding. And the Bible is saying this morning, wisdom is crying. He's crying. And understanding has put forth her voice. The usage of the word cry and putting forth her voice. And the second verse says, she standeth in the top of high places. The use of the personal pronoun, she, signified that wisdom is being personified as a person. And the Bible says that she standeth in the top of high places, by the way, in the places of the paths. In other words, anywhere human beings are found, walking, sitting, wherever, wisdom is there, crying, shouting. Why? Third voice. She crieth at the gates, at the entry of the city, at the doors. These are places that you see people. In those days, the gates of the cities have walls around them. And at the gate, it was like a community center where people met and took decisions for the city. And the Bible says that is where you find wisdom. Anywhere people are gathered like we have gathered here, you find wisdom there crying and shouting. And you see understanding stretching forth or also adding her voice to wisdom. The next verse. And the Bible says, unto you, O men. Have you seen that? So it's not like wisdom is just shouting in the air to the stars and the trees and everything. Wisdom deals with men. Vehicles don't need wisdom. They are metals. Trees don't need wisdom. They are metals. They don't need understanding. Human beings need wisdom. Human beings need understanding. I pray for you this morning that as wisdom speaks to you, you will hear. I say you will hear. Now, jump to verse 10. Now, wisdom is saying, verse 10, all of us ready, go. All of us ready, go. Pause. Who is speaking? Who is speaking? Wisdom says what? Receive my instruction. I've told you before, the easiest way to walk with God and see the word of God honored in your life is to receive God's instructions. You know why? Faith cometh by hearing, by the word of God. Sorry. But the Bible says that faith without works is dead. When you get born again, the biggest thing in your life, the big deuce in your life is about faith. But if your faith cannot work for you, your faith is dead. So faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. So if you hear the word of God, which is God's instruction, and you cannot receive it, you cannot obey it, you are good for nothing listening to the word of God. So wisdom says, receive my instructions. Remember, wisdom was crying wherever people were found, at the gates, at your doors, everywhere. Say, receive my instruction. In other words, God is crying this morning and saying, my children, receive instruction. Yeah. Receive instruction. And not silver and knowledge rather than gold. Receive my instruction and not silver, and receive knowledge rather than the choice of gold. Listen to me. All the things that we are running up and down for, working for day and night, Saturdays, Sundays, and all the excuses that the job is not giving me time, I can assure you one day they will be meaningless before you. Solomon said, I set my heart to examine that which is life. And Solomon decided to do all the vices that you can talk about. Married so many women, 700 of them, and several concubines, and did all the things, involved in science, involved himself in philosophies and everything. at the end of the day, he said, all is meaningless. And everything that I built for myself, they are all meaningless. I can assure you, one day, you will testify that these things are meaningless. So he says, God is talking here. It's wisdom. He says, receive my instruction. And don't be so crazy about silver. Silver simply means worth. That is not to say that you shouldn't work. That is not to say that you shouldn't make money. But he's saying that in addition to making money, receive instructions. Take my instructions. When I say go preach the gospel to every creature, go preach the gospel. In fact, Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, there's a very wonderful instructions over there. But seek ye first. Priority. Priority. Seek ye. You see, I can't have you finish the sentence for me. Seek ye. Again, seek ye. There. Then what happens? And then what? Then what? All means silver. Yeah. It includes silver. All also means what? Silver. Gold. Seek it first. Is that not an instruction? Yes, is that not an instruction?
Yes, it is.
It is an instruction. On my birthday, the eve of my birthday, I decided to pray. I said, God, I know by the word of God. I have the knowledge. I know that you have blessed everyone born again with all spiritual blessings. But they are all in our spirit, man. When they say heavenly places, it means it's spiritual. And they have been given to us already. I have in me the raised from the dead power, the power that raised Christ from the dead. I have all these things at work in me. You know what? I can figure it out. But I want Spirit of God to hear from you. I've learned it from the Word of God, but I want to hear from you how I can draw on all these spiritual blessings. You know how the answer came? In instruction. Yeah. It came in what? By instruction. By instruction. So now the back has been passed on to me. If I obey the instructions, I will see and I'll be able to draw all the spiritual giftings. I'll be able to draw it. But if I refuse the instructions, I become a failure. That is why God is saying here, I am wisdom speaking. Hear my instruction. Don't forsake instruction. Don't forsake instruction. For God's sake, don't forsake instructions. There are parents over here, and I pray all of you will become parents one day. That is how you will appreciate what it is. When your children begins to forsake your instructions. I know parents who have even added curses to instructions. This thing that I've been telling you, say you won't listen. Tomorrow when you start crying, don't say I didn't tell you. Don't say I didn't. How many of you have heard of what I'm saying before? If you have heard it, please. Yeah. This thing that I'm telling you. Mothers who are so desperate for their children to get married, especially their female children, girls to marry. They say, why? You see the man driving this beautiful car. You say you don't like it. What do you want? Tomorrow, when you don't get a husband, don't say that I'm the one who did you. Please. How many of you have heard so many of them? Yeah. Why are they saying so? Because they want their daughters to take the instructions of their parents. And sometimes what the mothers are saying is true, because we have some daughters, you don't know what they want. They want tall, they want fair. They want bankers. I didn't intend to say this, because when I say, some of you will laugh at me. One of my favorite shows on television, I don't want television much, and my wife has been laughing at me, all my children. When they hear me, they say, hey! One of my favorite programs is Date Rush. But I told you would laugh at me. One day, Selassie came home and we're watching something. I said, oh, please, the time is about 8 o'clock. Can you put it at TV3 for me to watch Date Rush? He said, you watch Date Rush? And then my wife added, you listen to your father. You'll be sitting here watching this and be insulting the people. And they don't understand why I watch it. I just want to understand the reason why some of our sisters choose people. You have all these rasta men. Now all the women have cornrowed their hair. And they come on the show and you see the women who come there to come and look for days choosing cornrowed. So one day, one guy came and said, if you take me home, Rasta, you know, the lady said, I can't take you home. You know why? My parents will not accept this thing that you have done. Then another guy came, he's a comedian. And a woman, he said, my question before I choose you is this. If you take me a comedian home and your father asks me, what work do I do? What will you say? Oh, sir, papa, oh, Jimia, na nkrofosri, na jumanu no. And they don't understand why I watch that. I just want to see the philosophy with which people do things. It's not because I'm so much interested in that. And most of the time, I predict, I said, all these things, they'll fail. All these things, they'll fail. They'll fail. They'll fail. I pray that none of you will go on Date Rush. If you want date, come. 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 Mrs. Ansor is clapping for me. Do you know why she's clapping for me? Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Anyway, Date Rush aside. For today is Sunday, you can meet me around 8 o'clock on Date Rush. Anyway, so that day, Selassie also joined me. We sit down with, and then before I realized, he has also started insulting the people. I say, yeah, I want more of you on board. Amen. look at Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. Please, can you help me read this? All of us, ready, go. Do you remember that just a while ago, wisdom was crying? Did you remember? Wisdom was what? Yeah. Wisdom was crying. And understanding added her voice. So, the Bible says that how do you get wisdom? The fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord simply means that having to hear God and you obey. Is that not it? Is that not it? And you obey. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. But fools despise what? Please, with all due respect, I don't mean to say anybody here is a fool. Please, you know me, I won't do that. But this is the word of God as it stands. It says, fools despise. That is why wisdom was saying that, please, forsake not. Forsaking means you don't have respect. It's only fools who despise wisdom and instruction. Yeah. Listen to me. If you're a parent over here, pray God gives you wisdom and what we call sound judgment and discretion. Sound judgment and discretion. So that you don't have to eat up your words and your children comes back to you and tell you that, Daddy, what you told me was wrong. Or the advice you gave me was wrong. Are you here somewhere? Yeah, pray. It's something that you should ask God. I've never, ever given any instruction to any of you, which is a wrong instruction. When you are doing something, I tell you that what you are doing, it will take you to a place you will not like one day. It's not a wrong instruction. Because the Bible makes us to understand what instruction is. Let's go to chapter 8, Proverbs. And let's jump quickly to verse 33 and 34. Sam, can you read it for me?
Yes, sir. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 33 to 34. Hear instruction and be wise, and refuse it not.
Again?
Hear instruction and be wise, and refuse it not.
All right, pause there for a moment. When wisdom speaks and instruction adds her voice, we've been admonished earlier that you should not forsake it. Now, even just chapter 8 alone, you notice that about two or three times, wisdom kept on saying that, hear instruction. Forsake not instruction. Now, here again, we have been told that, hear instruction and be hear instructions and be wise. What it means that instruction can make you wise. Are you here? Instructions can make you wise. Can make you wise. Lack of instruction can make you foolish or fools. That's why I love to have conversation with my children. Instructions will make you what? Wise. Give her the scripture again. And refuse it not. 34 verse. Blessed is the man that heareth me. Let's end it over there. Blessed is the man that heareth me. Yeah. Blessed is the man that heareth instruction. Blessed is the man. That word blessed also means happy. 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 Who wants to be happy? Who wants to be glad? Hear instructions. Turn to your brother, your sister. Say, hear instructions if you want to be happy. Hallelujah. Hearing doesn't mean just hear me as I speak. Do what the instruction says you should do. That's what it means. To obey is better than sacrifice. Are you here? Yeah. So, he says, blessed is the man that heareth me. Heareth me. Wisdom says that if you hear me and you take my instruction, you'll be blessed. And this morning, wisdom is speaking to you. I said, this morning, wisdom is speaking to you. Oh, hallelujah. Wisdom is speaking to you. Halabraskata dadea. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Go. Because I've said to you that do not look at instructions. In fact, if you want to look at the Hebrew meaning of the word instruction, it means correction, reproof, and all those things. But generally, instruction also means a command. My grandchild is about 15 months. And then she comes to us either once or twice a week, the whole day. And he likes to go and fidget with my internet. So anytime he's going there, say, stop, don't do it, stop, don't do it. Now, he has come to a place where anytime we are in the hall and he takes steps towards that place, he will pause. And then he will turn his back and look at my face. And then he will look at grandma's face. And then I'll also give him a stern watch. And then you stand there, stand. Then when we all burst into laughter, then you laugh the loudest. And then, I think he's the one making the noise there. And then you return. That baby of 15 months can remember that grandma, grandpa had always warned him not to go. I think he's always thrilled by the telephone. He's thrilled by the telephone. And that's the attraction. And not the internet thing per se. So he knows that instructions have been given not to go there. Right? The instruction this morning is simple. Let us go and preach the gospel to every creature. Don't go far. They are just around your area where you live. Where you live. They are there. That's the best place you can reach out. So when you are coming to church, you live there. You hold their hands and come along with them. And you'll be adding treasure in heaven. And not only in heaven, the Bible said that the person who wins souls is what? Wise. In other words, you receive wisdom. And when you go on date rush, you won't go and be choosing Rasta men and co. That's not the people you go and choose. May God give you wisdom. So let's finish this one today. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Let's go preach the gospel first and bring in the souls. And the Bible says that silver, gold, wealth, job, marriage, whatever we are looking for, they will be added. If you are not married and you don't say amen, it's you. It's you. I say husbands will be added. If you need silver and gold and wealth, I said all will be added. But the instruction says, let us go and win souls. Hallelujah. Let's look at this and then we are done for today. Mark 16:15. The instruction of wisdom this morning says, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Don't worry. You don't need to worry about the baptism. You bring the person to church. We'll do the baptism for the person. But he that believeth not shall be damned. 17. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. And these signs. So I do not see the instruction as a command. I see it as a mandate. I see it as a mandate. There's no way that I preach the gospel to somebody and the person is demon possessed and the demon will remain in that person. Never, ever. Never, ever. Because I have the mandate, if I preach the gospel, signs will follow me. Signs will follow me. Signs will follow me. Signs will follow me. How can you be a Christian and you don't want signs? How can you be a Christian and you don't want signs? I'm asking a question. Do you really want signs? Oh, Pastor, I like signs, but I don't want to be casting out demons. But the signs is not only about demons. He said, you shall also speak. You shall also speak. You shall speak with what? Or that one too you don't like. Okay, you don't like casting out demons. You don't like speaking with new tongues. Okay, how about you shall take serpents. Somebody said, hey, if new tongue I don't like, why should I like taking serpents? All right, you don't like taking serpents also. What about when you drink any deadly thing, they shall not hurt you? You like? If you like, give me away. That one there you like, give me away. That one you like. But what you don't like? The thing is that whether you like or you don't like, sometimes you go and buy some ice water, it's contaminated. Now I'm going to make sure that everybody likes. You go and drink something. You eat something. You buy something in town. Wache, whatever. Not too long ago, I think this year, some people ate some wache around Oyarefa or something. And they people went to the hospital. That's what we are talking about. So how many of you like, if you eat any deadly thing, it shall not hurt you? Give me wave. Give me wave. Give me wave. Give me wave. Yeah. So go. Tell somebody, so go. If you like it, go. Amen. I see everything God tells me as a mandate. Not just a command. It's a mandate. Because the benefit outweighs the so-called, in brackets, command. If you are here and you find it difficult to go, I've told you already, the dream that somebody told me, okay? The woman said, why are you people praying for souls? Why are you people calling for church growth? Why are you going for evangelism? Why? You are disturbing us. It's demonic. It's demonic in the sense that the devil doesn't want you to be able to cast them out. Because when you go, the signs will follow you. When you go, you take deadly things, they shall not harm you. The devil doesn't want you to have those signs following you. Can I get your amen? Amen. Let me get your loudest amen. Amen. Verse 20. And they went forth. I like this one. And they went forth because they obeyed. They obeyed. That's why I like my brothers, the Nigerians. So, if they were the people that I was talking to, by now they are carrying their Bibles. They are carrying their Bibles. They are not as passive as us. They are very active people. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them. How many of you would like the Lord to work with you? Carry your Bible now. Eddie, you don't have a Bible, you see? Is that your Bible? Is it a phone? It's a phone, okay. I say, carry your Bible. It's an instruction. Okay? Yeah. This is it. He has given you the word. The word. He says, just go and preach it. And signs will follow you. And signs will follow you. Signs will follow you. As many as have agreed, may signs follow you. This word that I'm preaching, may God honor it in your life. I say, may God honor it in your life. May God honor it in your life. Everywhere you open your mouth to talk about the word of God and to win them, may God honor your life. May God honor the word in your life. May signs be honored in your life. I say, may signs follow you and the word honored in your life. Amen. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs following them. The Lord will work with you. The Lord will work with you. The Lord will work with you. There are some miracles that you are looking for. The Lord will work with you. The Lord will work with you. Bow down your heads. Wisdom. It's a prayer. Give me my microphone. This morning, if you really love God and you love this family, I want you to talk to that demon that makes you think that preaching the gospel is a difficult thing, or I don't have time to preach the gospel, or I am ashamed. Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power. It is the power. Our power comes from the gospel. Don't let the devil cheat you and take away the power from you. Let the power be in your mouth. Where are the rest of the instrumentalists? Speak to that demon. That demon. You sometimes, I know here, I know that God has been telling some of you, if people come your way, God tells you, preach, or this is your neighbor, go and talk to the person. And yet, either you are ashamed, either you are afraid, something, whatever it is that is making you give the excuse, it is demonic. It is what? Demonic. At least cast out that demon. Cast out that demon today. Cast it out. When you leave here, I've been praying that the Holy Spirit will speak to you. The Holy Spirit has been speaking to you. I know God answers my prayers. He's been speaking to you, but you've been making excuses. I'm ashamed. What if they sack me? What if they insult me? But the Holy Ghost continues to speak to you. When you leave here, they will continue to speak to you. Cast it out right now. Cast it out. The Bible says that the righteous is as bold as a lion. You are a bold person, but don't let the devil make you coward. Don't let the devil make you a coward. The Bible says the righteous, every one of you, if you are born again, you are a righteous person. And the Bible says the righteous is bold, Jesus, as a lion. Pray. Pray.
Then I'm a founder. Yehovah Rasi, Wani Yao, Yema Mida. Then I'm in Fanshe, Yehovah Nemu, Wani Yao. Yeah, my da. Me man in Kwanji, crew on Isu, Nama Bonidi, Atramase, Nina, Echirani. Eddie Adansi, Wonia, yeah, mommy, da, mama, ni kwa.
Meshirani Kadebahayaza Namedi Ada Ansi Wonia Mia Yemami Denami Fanda Yehoara.
Come on, everybody, rise up. Rise up now.
Wonia Mia.
Let the Holy Ghost speak to
you.
If you can, lift up your hands. If you can.
Then I'm in fire. Yehovah Nemu. Wonia Mia. Man in Quajinusu, man in Quachi, Cruani, so Nama Boni, Baboni D, Achra, my son, Yina, Machirani, Machirani, you know, Namedi. Adansi Onia Onia Yema Mema Ninkwaji Kruwane. Hallelujah. Nama Boni Meboni Di Atra Masenina Meshirani. Hey, Namedi Ada. Hallelujah. Wonia. Yeah. Memani Kwaji Nusho. Memani Kwaji. Hey. Nama boni di, nama boni. Achira mansa,
achira
mansa. Di, mechira ni. Oh, medi ada. Yeah. Yeah. Man in Quadi crew on a sense, man in Quadi crew on a so. Ah, my bonny dee, my bonny dee, my bonny dee. Ah, Betty Ronnie dee, Betty and Nancy. Hallelujah. Ah, oh, yeah. Meman in Quachi. Cruani su. Nama bonidi. Me bonidi. Achra masenina. Meshira Udino, as long as I live, baby, you are dancing. Wonia, oh, yeah, man. Mama ni kwaji kruwa ni sulese. Mama ni kwaji. Hey! Nama boni di. Achira masenjina. Achira
masenjina.
Mechirani di.
Mechirani
di.
Namedi going to lift up your voice. That dream that the sister had, it means that there are powers that are fighting the kingdom of God from taking the souls from the kingdom of the devil into the kingdom of his dear son. Today, this morning, this very morning, I want you to lift up your voice. Speak to that voice. Cast it out. Cast that woman out. Cast that devil out. And free yourself. Free yourself from shame. Free yourself from excuse. Free yourself from excuse. Free yourself from anything. I'm so busy. But you know there's time. Anytime the devil touches you and you fall sick, you spend so much time. But the Lord has been keeping you safe. Spend this very hour. Spend this very hour. Speak to that devil that the kingdom of God shall progress from shore to shore, and I shall be one of the people who will go out and preach the gospel with the authority, with God backing me, with signs in the name of Jesus. Speak to that demon. We shall preach the gospel. We shall bring in soul. We shall advocate for church growth in the name of Jesus. Every chair in this room shall be filled with new souls in the name of Jesus, God. Makato, kare katoka, rapapapapoka, shandarabatoka, bababeka, rebeka tarabapoka, shatarabade, brekete, brekete, baya, rapapapapoka, badabade, rapapapapoka, badabakere, badabade, rapapapapoka, shandarabapoka, rakapakatere, brekete, rekapadabada, rebapapapoka, shekebadabade, brakabada, rakabado, brakabade, kabadabade, Rapenzo Gabara Baba Baba, Rabato Peria Dacapea Balueta, Zebi Paraba Baba, Ipalue Bracata Baba, Iparaba Baba, in the name of Jesus, Palayapa Rapa Baba, Imazate Capara Baba Baba, Paraba Dita Brados Gaba, Penuacaya Gabera Baba, Imantale Braba Batoke Prada Baba, Rapazi Potaya Peribia Baba, Paroca Pica Paraba Baba, Deny you the power of God, the power of the gospel. Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. If you are ashamed, the Bible says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. It is the power of God unto salvation. He doesn't want you to make the preaching of the gospel your priority. He doesn't want you to make the preaching of the gospel your priority. But the Bible says, seek first. Preach the gospel first. Preach the gospel first, and all other things shall be added unto you. Pray that you will not be taken, by that web of the devil. Pray.
Ekaro shakara bado sele de brekaya rapaka paka 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 pa rakapa kapaka paka pa rakapa kapaka pa rapaka paka paka pa rakapa kapaka paka pa rakapa kapaka paka pa rakapa kapaka paka pa rapapa papa deliver yourself. He doesn't want you to have the blessings that go with the preaching of the gospel. Rabakata rabapapapa rakapapapapa koshakabadabade rapapapako shakabade kabadabade rabadokabadabade rakadakaya rakadakabaya katabakatabaya rakabakatabakabaya rapapapakashakabadabada rapapapapo rapapapapapa rekeberekabakaba rapapapapo rakaba rakabakaba rapapapapo rakapapa Come on, everybody, break through, free yourself so that the power of the gospel will be in your mouth. The power of the gospel will be in your mouth. Paul said, it is the power, the gospel is the power, it is the power. Kato kabada bade kaba. Rapapapapo, rakapapapo, rakapaka de kabata kakeba kata badoka. Rapapapapoka, rakapaka de kaba. Yepato baba, katarabaka, katarabaka tabaka. Rapapapapo kabata ya. Pray, everybody, don't keep quiet. In the name of Jesus.
So, Fremia Bibiara, Midian Jebe Jesu, O Sande, Ononowo, Adam Shira, Meye Chuma Meradi, Midimihuna, Mimina, Meye Radine Chuma, Nameyani, Sam Shira. So for me, I be the one. Hey, me the energy, but you so. Oh Sunday, on and on, I do Shira. May I Juma? I'm ready. Hey, may I Juma? A Juma, I'm ready. Say for me, I be there. Be the energy, but Jesus, oh Sunday, on and on. I don't share. May I do it? I'm ready. May I do it? I do it. I'm ready. Say for me, I be there. Be the energy, but Jesus, oh Sunday, on and on. I don't share. May I do more? With your hands lifted up, can you lift your hands up? May I do more? I'm ready. Say for me, I be there. Me the energy, but you so. Oh Sunday, yeah. May I do more? Hey, Kadabaha. When I will fray in, say, Emra, may you wait, Juma. When I will fray in, hey, say, Emra, may you wait, Juma. When I will fray in, say, Emra, may you wait, Juma, ready? Yabo, Yabo, Yabo. When I will fray in, say, I'm ready, Juma. When I will pray, Ayakadaya. Say, I'm ready, Juma. When I will pray, say, I'm ready, Juma. A radio, Yabo. Yabo.
Yabo.
Mira, yes, Mami.
Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. Good Lord, lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Peace be established in all realms of your life. You're going out, you're coming in, your relationship, your domestic affairs, your business affairs, in every neighborhood, may there be peace between you and your neighbors, in the mighty name of Jesus. The grace of life that you have inherited will be multiplied in your life throughout this season in your life. Go and come back with a testimony that the grace of God is authentic and is working in your life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for joining. We hope you were blessed. Great grace, great power, great riches, great mercies are all yours.